Dear students of class 6, welcome to my class once again. Today I shall discuss a new topic. The name of the topic is essay writing. The name of the topic is essay writing. Chapter number 24, essay writing. So please open your book so that it will be easy for you to understand clearly, easily. So what is essay? An essay is a long piece of composition. An essay is a long piece of composition. An essay is generally a piece of writing that gives the author's own argument. So an essay is a long composition. Essay expresses a point of view or an opinion. Through essay or in essay we express, for example, suppose I am writing an essay, I will express my opinion. If I am writing about a particular topic, for example, my father, then I will write my opinion about my father, or I will write my point of view about my father. So essay expresses a point of view or an opinion. If you are writing an essay about my principal, then you will write what you feel about your principal. So you will write your opinion, or you will write what you feel about your principal or about your school. So an essay should have following features. An essay should have following features. A suitable title. A suitable title. TITLE. That means if in exam question, will come like this: write an essay about your school. So we'll write title, we'll write like this: my school, SCHOOL. The title will be my school. So an essay should have, as I said you earlier, essay should have following features. That means number one is a suitable title. There should be a suitable title. For example, my principal, my school, like this. So there should be a suitable title. The body of the essay should be logically organized. Number two is logically organized. Body of the essay, ESSAY, essay should be logically organized. SHOU should be logically organized. ORGANICED. So the body of the essay should be logically organized. For example, in your book essay is there about my principal. So you can see Mr. Ashok Verma is my principal. He is a man of about 40 years. If we write he is a man of about 40 years at the end, then it will be, the essay will not be logically arranged, so logically organized. So our essay should be logically organized. The next is, the language of the essay should be simple and clear. The language of the essay should be should be clear, should be simple and clear. This is the third point. The body of the essay should be simple and clear. Third is, the body, BODY, body of the essay, ESS, the body of the essay should be, SHOU, should be simple SIM, simple and clear, 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 clear. So there should be a suitable title. The essay should be logically organized. The language of the essay LANGUAGE. The language of the essay should be simple and clear. It should be simple and clear. And I hope you know what is simple and clear. So we should write the essay. Number fourth is, you should write the essay in your own language. In your own language, you should not memorize and write. For example, if you open your book at page 109 and then turn over to next page, you will see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 essays are there. So you should not memorize. You should read the essays given in your book. You should not memorize. You should write essay in your own language. In your own language. If you write or if you memorize from your book, then it will be, as I said to you in the beginning, that essay expresses a point of view or an opinion. That means if I am writing an essay on my father, then I am expressing my opinion about my father. So if you write in your exam, suppose write an essay about your father, if it is given, and you memorize from the book and write in your exam, then it will be not your opinion, it will be the opinion of the writer. It will be the point of view or opinion of the writer. So if you write in your own language, then what? You will get good marks. You will get good marks. So essay should be written in your own language, and you should not memorize and write. I hope you have understood this. Fifth is, when you will go in class 8, then you will learn that we should write essay at least in 3 paragraphs. At least in 3 paragraphs. The first paragraph, at the beginning, there will be an introduction. The first paragraph will contain introduction. Second is the body, whatever we want to write about a particular topic. Then conclusion. Then we have to conclude that essay. But in class 6, what we have to do, if we don't write introduction also, then it will be okay. But we should write at least in 2 paragraphs. If we write an essay, we should not write for example this is a page, this is a, or you think that this blackboard is a page. So if you are writing an essay, then if you start from there, first line, second line, third line, fourth line, fifth line, sixth line, seventh line, and then suppose you think that this is your essay and you have not changed the paragraph, then it will not look nice. So you have to change the paragraph. For example, first line, second line, third line, fourth line, then right from here, fifth line, sixth line, seventh line, like this. So I hope you have understood this. So you should write essay like this. Once again, I am repeating. Essay expresses a point of view or an opinion. An essay should have following features. Already I have written on the board earlier. So the body of a suitable, there should be a suitable title. The body of the essay should be logically organized. The language of the essay should be simple and clear. It should be written in our own language. We should not memorize and write. I hope you have understood. So follow the rules which I have discussed while writing essay. Remember this. Do not memorize, please do not memorize, and write in two, at least in two paragraphs. In class 8, when you will go in class 8, then you will learn more rules about essay. More rules about essay. So today, for example, if I want to write about my mother, then how I will write? Listen carefully, you may also write. And please go through all the essays given in your book. So you will get an idea. You will get an idea, and the essays given in your book will help you to write in your exam perfectly. So I am, suppose if I want to write an essay about my mother, then how I'll write? My mother is a housewife. Her name is dash dash. For example, her name is Salma Begum. She is very simple and gentle lady. My mother is the most influential person for me in my life. She is not only hardworking, but also very dedicated towards her works. She gets up before the sun rises and starts her daily activities. My mother is very beautiful and a kind-hearted woman who manages everything at our home. Then you can change the paragraph. I have a special respect for my mother, as she is my best friend. I have a special respect for my mother, as she is my first teacher, who not only teaches the chapters from my books but also shows me the right path of life. She takes proper care of each member of the family. She works all the time but never complains, unlike us. That means if we do, for example, if we work whole day, then we'll complain, yeah, work is very difficult, hand is paining, I got hurt, I got injured, so we'll complain. But our mother never complains. She continuously works and she never complains. We cannot describe our mother through an essay. We can write books and books. If we want to write about our mother, we cannot describe her, or we cannot summarize her in 150 words, 200 words. So she takes proper care of each member of the family. She works all the time but never complains, unlike us. She is the backbone of our family. I love my mother very much and pray to Almighty for her long life and good health. So many points I have missed. Why? Because I cannot write about my mother in 150 words, 200 words, 1,000 words, 5,000 words. I can write about my mother many books. So you have to write your essay like this, your opinion. We should, in essay, we have to write our opinion, not someone else's opinion. If you write an essay, you memorize from book and write in the exam, then it's not your opinion. You are writing opinion or point of view of somebody else. If you write from the book, then you are writing the opinion of the writer, not yours. So we should write our opinion. So like this we have to write essay. So I hope you have understood how to write essay. And many essays are there in your books. Please read those essays carefully so that you will develop ideas, so that you will develop ideas. And the essays given in your book will help you immensely to develop ideas, and you will get good marks. So I hope you have understood how to write essay. This is the end of this class, end of this chapter. If you find any problem while going through the video, please call me at night from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. every day. Thank you.